Hey, at least you're up. I've begun to think you're going into hibernation early this year.
Hey, it's Saturday, bro.
What's this?
Some sort of medal. It's from Vlad. He left it for me.
Looks military.
Yeah.
Coming to watch Danny and Snow?
Yeah, I suppose. Do you reckon it'll be all right? Vlad.
I don't know. Come on, let's go.
Well, this is it. I hope all those late nights don't leave their mark.
No.
I'm all focus. And the taxi girl. No girl, I suppose. You could say that.
Where's Tom?
You know Tom, ploughing through the pool. He's worried about his times or something.
Hey, I thought you had an extra training session with Sid.
Yeah, I did. But I pulled this muscle, you see. Evie. Sandy, if I lose this job at the paper, I mean, I've got to prove myself. I want to get published. Could be a story in this. Brett! Over here.
Tats! Long time no see.
Yeah.
How's the gymnastics going?
Good.
So, are you going to be barking for me?
I might. I just might.
Nah, I reckon you're back in one of your own. Hanging out for old Big Mouth over there.
I don't know. Girls got to keep her options open. I might barrack for both of them.
Nah, just barrack for the winner. Me.
Good luck.
Cheers.
Woo! Brett! Woo!
Shut up.
Danny boy, thought you'd retired.
Afraid of the competition, Bennett.
Competition? Not round here, mate. If you see any, let me know.
Don't worry, mate, you're thrashing.
Yeah.
Hey, Bennett, see this back. Get used to it.
Gee, Rodriguez, I'm shaking in my boots.
Yeah, you will be. Oh, you're bad.
Would all competitors please report to the starting area? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 1996 Lakes Classic. This is a 10-kilometre course around the lakes with a number of steep climbs and reverse camber turns which should test the riders. Last year's winner was Phil Johnson from the Hill Cycling Club.
Coming through.
And you got it.
That competitive spirit's alive and rocking.
Yeah. What happened?
Peloton pile-up.
You okay? How's your leg?
I live.
How fast were you going?
Fast enough.
Came around the corner, there it was, bang. At least you're okay.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Brett Bennett's not there.
Why? What happened?
I don't know. They were taking him off in an ambulance.
What?
Yeah, he had some sort of brace around his neck. Looks serious, Dan.
No, it's just a precaution. Just won't want to get out facing the winner. Better be okay. Next time I beat him, I want to see the look on his face.
It's okay, the frame was damaged.
At least something isn't.
I saw you move in on Brett's line out there.
Well, then you must have seen him move in on mine. So what?
You caused the pile-up, Rodriguez.
What?
It was dangerous, right?
Oh, bull. I was riding as smooth as anyone else was.
You were riding to win and stuff anyone that got in your way.
What the hell is he talking about? I was practically at the finish line when Brett came off.
Forget about it, mate. Just a sore loser.
It was Rodriguez and Bennett, neck and neck around the final turn. Bennett ahead by a nose, but no weight. No prejudging here, folks. Rodriguez rides straight past Bennett and takes the lead from the rest of the peloton, leaving him for dead.
Boring. Get to the gory bits.
But wait. Bennett and Cerveso tackle each other to the ground with their cycles.
Oh, this is so boy.
It's a disaster waiting to happen. And here it comes. Steve Snowy Bowles races around the corner, leading the peloton into a spectacular pile-up, while Danny Rodriguez takes the race home without a worry. Woo-hoo!
Just a race.
Rodriguez strikes again.
What's that supposed to mean?
You know, the pile-up.
No, I don't.
Oh, come on. Everyone knows you're a bit of a cowboy.
You want to spell that out?
Just that you push things too far sometimes. It's meant to be a sport, isn't it?
Yeah, and I won.
What about the pile-up?
I'd shut up if I was you, Stewie. You don't know what you're talking about, mate.
Put a sock in it, Stu.
Like I said, I didn't cause it.
Then who did?
He doesn't know what he's talking about, right, Dan?
All I'm asking is, where do you draw the line?
Look, Stu, if you're in a peloton riding at about 80 or 90 kilometres an hour, and if you fall off at that speed, you're stuffed. Not like in athletics.
All right. Except when Danny wants something, he does know when to stop. He probably pushed the other guy to the limit.
Look, if Brett Banner was up there with Danny, he compared to us pushing it to the limit as well.
Danny, Snow, I'd like to see you both in my office right now, if you don't mind.
What's going on?
I'm afraid I've got some bad news. As you know, there was an accident during the race this morning and Brett Bennett was taken to hospital. We've just heard that Brett died a short time ago as a result of head injuries sustained in the accident. He suffered a severe brain hemorrhage.
This comes as a terrible shock to all of us. And I know both of you knew Brett and had raced with him before. Now, if you want to talk, both Chris and I are available. Or if you'd rather talk to a counsellor, that's fair enough, we can organise it. Now, all I'm saying is, if you need to talk, do it. Get it off your chest.
They'll be training tomorrow as usual. In the circumstances, we'll take a ride for Brett.
How do you die in a bike race?
Well, he hit his head.
Well, don't they wear helmets?
Yeah, they're compulsory, but they don't work all the time. Depends on how you hit, I guess. You know, I was talking to him right before the race. I used to go out with him.
What?
Oh, well, not for very long, you know, it was a while ago, but he had a really nice smile. And his eyes, he had really nice eyes.
Which one was he? What did he look like?
He didn't look like the kind of guy you'd expect to die.
And what's that supposed to mean, Stewie?
You just wouldn't expect him to die, that's all.
Then who would you expect to die?
Well, I don't know. Sick people.
Oh, it gives me the shivers.
I can't believe we just die and that's all.
Why not? I mean, just a bunch of atoms. We die, we break down, we go back down to the earth.
And what about our consciousness?
What, a soul? It's just a concept invented by humans so we feel like there's some kind of reward after death.
Well, what if we turn into spirits?
Maybe we're reincarnated and we all come back.
Not more training.
Space time for Cornelius. Cornelius kicks wrong. The words fall forward, down in front of foot. He kicks towards the top of the square.
I can't remember properly. I can't remember if I cut in too quickly. Maybe I put the other guy off balance. Maybe I did push him into Brent. If I did, does that mean I killed him?
Of course you didn't, Dan.
Young cyclist who died shortly after arriving at hospital. Family and friends were in shock today after the accident that cycling officials described as tragic. Time for the weather now. It's over to Carl.
Thanks, Kathy. Yes, the weather.
Bad business. Bad day. Difficult to come to grips with.
Thanks.
People are saying Danny had something to do with the accident. Some of Brett's team members.
Times like this is always talk.
What do you think about Danny?
I think that when people are emotionally overcharged, they can make stupid accusations.
Chris, if he's broken the rules, I want to know about it.
Danny plays hard but fair. He's got nothing to hide.
Look, at the end of the day, a 19-year-old boy is dead and something's going to come down from somewhere. I just want to be ready for it. I think we'd better have a chat to your boys.
Dan?
It's probably just the council that Don was talking about in the office, right?
Snowy?
What if it was Danny's fault? What'll happen to him?
I don't know.
It's gonna be all right, Dan.
I'll see you in a minute.
Will they take him away?
Hey, Don will sort it out.
Danny.
Take a seat, Danny. A rider from Brett's cycling club came forward. Roddy Cerveza?
Yeah.
He was the one up the front between you and Brett. Now, he said at the time you cut in, something hit his wheel and it made him swerve. He was pretty cut up about it.
It's okay, mate, you didn't do it. He said you didn't push him into Brett. He hit a stone as you were passing. That's why he lost his balance.
A stone?
That's why he swerved into Brett.
So, it wasn't my fault?
No, you can see for yourself. Someone got it on video. It was an accident, pure and simple.
Right. Thanks.
So, you can relax.
So you're training this afternoon?
Sure. At least you know it wasn't your fault, Dan.
You gonna watch the tape? In a while.
Good, isn't he?
20 k's at your own pace. I don't want you to push yourselves too hard today. And let's remember Brett. This one's for him.
Thank you.
Got a flat?
Pick up your bike, Danny, and keep riding. Danny, don't let this get to you. Fight it. What are you looking at? Get on with it. Danny, come back here now.
Or what, Chris?
Do you think he really knew what was happening?
I don't know.
I never really thought about death before. And when the crowd's watching you and the adrenaline's pumping and you feel like you can live forever, how can you go from that to death?
Brett did.
These flowers, they'll fade and rot. And the cars will keep passing and life goes on. I heard you freaked out at training yesterday.
I didn't freak. I just didn't feel like it.
Danny, whatever you are feeling, it's okay. Just don't lock everyone out. Maybe we can help.
For what it's worth, I do have a fair idea how you're feeling. I've been there. I've seen people injured die right next to me in a race. It turns you inside out, scares the hell out of you. But in the end, you deal with it. You move on, because you have to. Maybe you think it's okay to behave like you did yesterday. Maybe you think I should go easy on you because you're going through a rough time. But I know what your real problem is.
I don't have a problem.
Oh, yeah, you do. You're scared.
I'm not scared of anything.
That's why you dropped your bike yesterday. You saw the riders in front of you, the pack. Normally, you would have been right in there. But yesterday, you couldn't face it. This isn't about death, Dan. It's about fear.
That's bull.
You've got to beat this. Because while you're scared, you're dangerous. You're no good to me. You're no good to the team. And most of all, you're no good to yourself.
Do you mind? I'm trying to get a little rest here.
You've got to get back on that bike, Danny, or it's over for you.
Nobody knows where he is. Snow?
No, he wasn't there when I got up.
Guess he's got to sort things out for himself.
Sounds to me like he's lost his nerve.
Hey, if you'd been running against someone and then they died, you wouldn't be doing much better yourself.
I wasn't getting at him, it's just... Well, Danny's always on top of things and... Well, I don't know, it's strange. Seeing him like this. I wonder where he is.
Competition, Bennett.
Competition? Not rowdy, mate.
see any, let me know.
You missed breakfast, eh? Stewie figured out what the crunchy bits are in the muesli. He reckons they're baked crickets. Yeah, I'll see you out there then.
Problem with the bike. Fix? Yep. Pick up the pace, fellas. This isn't a holiday.